HBO is producing and co-producing documentary films since 2007. We are not concentrating on having many documentaries, but we are concentrating on having high-quality documentaries. We have an advertising of HBO which says it's not TV, it's HBO. So we search for cinematic films, for very strong stories with drama potential, for and also it's important who are the filmmakers, what is the ambition of the filmmakers, because at HBO we are really concentrating on quality. We want to co-produce films that are interesting for the festivals, but also films that are very interesting for the audience, because it's very important to reach audience and also to have a good PR, to have a press attention on the films. So for that we put a lot of efforts into the production. We are financing development. We are helping people going to the pitching forums, finding co-producers. Also in the pitching forums we are often searching for new films. We work with the filmmakers very closely during all the production and editing. The whole process is usually quite long. Average time of production of an HBO documentary is 4 years. So, and in some cases it is even longer. 10, 14 years we had also such case. Because time is an important thing in documentaries, both for the shooting, because we want to see some development of character, as for the editing, because the editing phase is very important and there is where the story is shaping. So, yes, we do it. We do about 10 documentaries every year. In Romania, we are releasing 2 or 3 documentaries every year. Some of these films were very successful. For example, our film World According Ion B, made by Alexander Nanau, received an Emmy Award. With Alexander, we continued with Toto and His Sisters, which was a film nominated for European Film Award. It is the European Oscar. And also the film won like 25 or even more, I don't know, but many, many awards all over the world. So we have very successful films. Another one might be Chuck Norris versus Communism. That was a co-production with a British company. So we have successful films, so we are preparing more films and we will continue doing this. I don't think that documentaries are not appealing to audiences. I travel a lot around the world. I see in festivals, even here in Sibiu, I just entered the room, they have Astra Junior. The room is full of children. Okay, this is a school that brings children to screening of documentary films, but this is work with the audiences. This is, you have to grow your audience. You have to make audience understand what is a good documentary. You have to constantly offering good content. I think it's also on the side of the filmmakers. We have to always think about the audience. We have to prepare good stories and have in mind not only the artistic view of the filmmaker, but also the feelings, who is our target audience and how will this audience accept these films. I am pretty aware of the problem with cinemas. There are not many cinemas in Romania, and people don't have many opportunities to watch the films. But it's again about people. My answer lies in another movie, HBO movie. We have done a film about an old cinema, Dacia, and it's called Cinema Mon Amour. And it's about a guy who is running a cinema and is trying to repair the cinema, is trying to change the chairs, make the heating, is showing the films to audiences, even it's freezing in the cinema hall. And at the end, the cinema got, after the film was released, got renovated. And I am very glad because this guy is my Facebook friend. So I regularly see what is happening in Cinema Dacia, and it's just exceptional. So as in cinema, as in documentary making, it's about your approach to the thing. And you have to start in one cinema, and maybe it's a good example, and you can do in another cinema. I think that festivals are important, and if these children like was by watching here documentaries today, if they have a good experience, they would like to follow this. And the truth is that there are many cinema releases of documentaries that are sold out also. It's a trend, young generation is searching for documentaries. And for me personally, okay, I am very subjective, but for me, no fiction can be better than a reality, because a good documentary protagonist in a documentary that I get in close relationship, it's for me, it's better than fiction, because it's inspiring for me, because I know this is true. And nowadays the technology changed so much that for documentary makers it is possible to make films with the same, very similar dramaturgy like the fiction. So the audience is really emotionally connected with the film, and it brings similar feelings like watching a fiction film.